Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm going to be talking today about the hottest comics releasing December 22nd, 2021. But first, please be sure to subscribe, like the video, comment down below what you're most excited for this week. I know I got a couple really good ones in here, so I'm dying to know what you guys are excited for. So we're going to dive right into my top picks, and we're starting off with Avengers Forever number 1. This is a brand new Avengers comic written by Jason Aaron, drawn by Aaron Cutter, and it's all new series starring the Avengers of the multiverse. And I mean, what great comic to start off right after that Spider-Man movie, especially after like the MCU has been really expanding on their multiverse. This book really seems to be embracing that, and I kind of like that. On a quest for cosmic vengeance, Ghost Rider finds himself roaring through the wasteland on a ruined Earth, where the great age of heroes never came to be, where hope is a four-letter word, and where his only ally in the coming battle against the greatest villains any universe has ever seen in the world's most wanted archaeologist, Tony Stark, the Invisible Ant-Man. Spinning out of the cosmic events of Avengers 750 and operating in lockstep with the Prime Avengers series, the next great Avengers saga begins here as the mightiest heroes of every Earth begin to assemble. So it just sounds really cool to have like these different multiverses in our comics and, you know, really just fully embracing that. So I can't wait for this one. We also have Miss Marvel Beyond number 1. It's part of a 5-part miniseries, and Miss Marvel returns in a new story from bestselling author Samira Ahmed. While on a break visiting her cousin in Chicago, Kamala Khan stumbles upon a robbery at a university physics lab and maybe sets off an explosion of interdimensional proportions in the process. Still, nothing she can't handle, or so she thinks, until she gets home and finds her whole world turned upside down and into a Bollywood set. Why is everyone she knows seen, and how can she make it stop? So I think this one's just like a really fun one to pick up, especially if you're interested in the new Miss Marvel show coming out next year. I think it's just like a really good introduction to her, and it's just like a really fun comedic comic, which, you know, every now and then is a really cool comic to pick up. We also have House of Slaughter number 3. This is a James Tynion and Tate Bromble with Chris Shannon and Werther DeLaRaya. And as the Houselers discuss the fate of the Last Butcher, Aaron and Jace escape the watchful eye of Helen and the White Mask and sneak into the forbidden outreaches of Chicago. Then, in present day, Aaron finally comes face to face with the monster that he's been tracking, which is much more powerful than expected. And although House of Slaughter has not performed as well as Something's Killing the Children, I do think it is still a very big potential for when, you know, the Something's Killing the Children TV show comes out. You know, Aaron could be a really, really big part of it, and having his storyline in the comics could mean a lot. So, you know, it's just really fun, especially if you're into that world, because you're really diving more into each character. We also have Batman One Dark Night number 1. It is a mini series of 3. It's a part of DC's Black Label, so it's those oversized prestige formats. And this one is written and drawn by Jock. Jock has been known for doing a lot of Batman work in the past. He's also worked with Scott Snyder, things like that. And from high above the sweltering summer streets of Gotham, Batman planned to escort the GCPD as a dangerous metahuman supervillain known as EMP, was transferred from a holding cell to his permanent home at Blackgate Prison. EMP's electrical powers posed a threat, but the situation was in hand, until it wasn't. Now every light in Gotham is out. The police are in disarray, and a broken, bleeding Batman must fight his way to Blackgate block by block, dragging EMP behind him. But the dark corners of Gotham hold many surprises, and EMP has many more shocks to deliver before the night is through. One of the most iconic Batman artists of the 21st century, the incomparable Jock, has focused all his storytelling powers on a tale of one very, very dark night in Gotham City. It's always darkest before the dawn, if it ever comes. So to me, this is just like a really fun, like, blackout Batman. And honestly, the covers have really cool because they are all black, but you can like turn them a certain way, and you know, they have like that light to them. So for me, I'm really excited to read this. I think he's a really great Batman artist, and I'm hoping that his writing is very up on par as well. I mean, I'm really excited for that new Batman movie. So let's hope this one's a good one. Now time for my series shoutouts. These are comics I don't necessarily think are going to be the hottest comics of the week, but if you're interested, be sure to check them out at your local comic book shop. We're going to be looking at Gunslinger Spawn number 3. This one's actually incredibly popular at my comic book store, and with good reason. I really enjoy Gunslinger Spawn. I think Gunslinger Spawn is probably the coolest Spawn right now. I think he is so interesting and really funny. So, Vampires, Guns, and Blood. The Gunslinger tries to protect the young man helping him, becomes face to face with a new villain from his Western past. And unfortunately, this could only lead to the return of much more dangerous plot run by the one supervillain Gunslinger can't defeat. So Gunslinger Spawn, like I said, really cool Spawn. I'm really looking forward to this comic, and I can't wait. I think the art Brett Booth is doing an incredible job as well. We also have King Conan number 1. It is a miniseries of 6. It's written by Jason Aaron and drawn by Asar. Conan's last stand at the edge of the world. Jason Aaron and Asar return to the saga of Conan in an all-new adventure that takes the story of the Cimmerian further than has ever been revealed in any media to date. As Robert E. Howard poised, when King Conan grows restless on the throne, he sails west toward an adventure unknown. Now see the first step of King Conan's fateful journey as an old and terrible danger threatens to end the saga of the Cimmerian once and for all. Don't dare miss the first issue of the adventure of a lifetime. So I really like Jason Aaron's Conan stories. I'm glad he's back and finishing his work because I did not think it was completely finished before. So I'm really, really looking forward to this. I hope it is just as violent, as cool as his previous ones, which I know he's keen now, so he's probably even more cool. We also have Moon Knight number 6, written by Jed McKay. I have been really loving Moon Knight. I think it is really fun. I love the art, and I can't wait for this issue. Beaten, bloody, his world burning down around him, this was how the Moon Knight was born, and now it's happening all over again. Outmaneuvered, outgunned, outplanned, Moon Knight's mysterious enemy has strode out of the shadows to strike, and when this villain strikes, they strike true. At the mercy of a maniac, will Moon Knight die yet again? So, Moon Knight, like I said, really, really fun. I think this is one of the better Marvel comics to come out as of right now. It might make my top 10 next year, we'll have to see. But it's definitely in for the running. We also have Venom number 3, written by Ram V, drawn by Brian Hitch. So Venom has been interesting so far. I definitely need to read this issue 3 to fully take in everything. So as everything Dylan Brock has come to know and love unravels around him, he's beginning to realize a terrible truth. The Venom symbiote is not a harmless pet, no matter how much it pretends to be one. It's an alien, a dangerous, violent, often bloodthirsty alien. Whatever bond it had with Dylan's father, Eddie Brock, special as it may have been, is gone, and Dylan might be soon too. I really enjoyed the Donny Cates Venom run, and specifically Dylan Brock was probably one of my favorite characters to come out of that. So I was really interested when Dylan had the symbiote and he was becoming Venom in this series. However, they definitely have changed Dylan's persona. And I'm not too fond of that. I think Dylan is a much more independent, hard-headed kid. And now he is very dependent on his father. And it makes him kind of a crybaby. And I don't know how I feel about that. I am interested to see what happened to Eddie from the first issue. Looks like this issue still might not give us answers to that. So, yes, I'm a little nervous for this one. I hope it does well. We also have Wastelanders Hawkeye number 1. Wastelanders Wolverine this past week did a really great job, and I'm really happy because it seems that more and more people are realizing that the old man Logan, the old man universe, isn't such a joke. It is really cool, and you should check it out. So this one is Deadly Accuracy. Witness the never-before-told story of Hawkeye's training with Stick the Man, formerly known as Daredevil. Clint Barton's sight may be gone, but his will to avenge is stronger than ever. And with the training and expert guidance of Matt Murdock, arrows will fly again. But what is Murdock's actual target? And how will this change Hawkeye's path in the Wastelands? This one issue you cannot afford to miss. So, especially if you're liking the Hawkeye show, I think getting introduced to Old Man Hawkeye would be really interesting to you, because it's very cool, and it definitely portrays kind of that Hawkeye merging as an older, more defensive, hard-headed Hawkeye, which I kind of like. So that's going to be it for me this week. There's plenty more comics that are releasing, but please be sure to go to your local comic book shop and check out all these comics and many, many more December 22nd. Have a great day!